If you're gonna be dumb, you gotta be tough. When you get knocked down, you gotta get back up. I ain't the sharpest knife in the drawer, but I know enough to know. If you're gonna be dumb, you gotta be tough.
Hi there and welcome back to another episode of Trespasser. This is Depressing Draws, and after rebooting this big red bastard, we are now free to go on our way and get the hell out of this bloody level. I just want to go in here again, just see if I can activate some little something here where I tussle with this big beige bastard. No, Anne does not want to say it, apparently.
Nerd Central.
Ah, there we go. Okay, so Anne has now declared this place to be Nerd Central. And as we can see, that you can just see if you step far enough away from the Cray computer, all the sound stops entirely. I'll just demonstrate. Yep. Just another classic bit of programming from the developers. And good God, did you hear the sound of that table? It was just bloody hell. It sounds like World War III breaking out. And these chairs, well... let's talk about the chairs the better, I think. So, let's go and see upstairs and see what we can find.
If the data is still in here, I could conceivably be a very rich girl. All it takes is a modem.
A modem is what we need. Okay, well, best place we check is the toilets first. Yes, can we find a modem in here? Is there a modem in here, perhaps? See if I can stick my arm in there. No, doesn't seem to be a modem in there. Let's just see in the toilet. No. Just a dirty bowl as per thing. Oh dear, Anne, oh dear, you know. And you were so sure that you were going to be able to find a modem in here. I mean, literally, you know, no thought given to the fact that you might actually... Oh, and there kicks in the Cray noise again. Absolutely marvellous. You know, and no thought given to this modem business that you might want, you know, a working phone line or an ISP provider or something. I don't know. Just, I feel like you haven't... thought this through, Anne. I feel like you just haven't given this enough thought. I mean, and even if you managed to find all of these things, do you think that you could extract that data out of that supercomputer? Let's go on to the main reason why we're up here, which is Nedry's room, which is right here.
I still believe Nedry left himself a back door, something about the hobbits or God knows what.
And as you see, he's obviously flipped over his desk in a fit of rage here, as we can probably expect from that character. And look at these big beige computers. I mean, can you remember having computers like this? It was brilliant. You could fit loads of stuff in there. Nowadays, like, PC towers are just not big enough to fit all your good wants in there. And what have we got here? We've got some Shadow Raiders 2. No, I can't read that. It's far too resolution. Excalibur. Martian Summer, Swords of Kandar, that sounds like a good one. Ooh, a mace, we'll get that in a minute. But of course, my personal favourite, Attack from Uranus. Well, couldn't resist putting in the Uranus joke in there, good developers. So, let's pick this bad boy up. Ooh, yeah, look at this. Look, some sort of imitation mace. And I tell you what, this is the only melee weapon in the game which is actually effective. And we'll demonstrate that a little bit later as I just demonstrate its effectiveness on the chair and what have you. Well, that's not a chair. That was a wall that I was hitting against. And that's a desk. So best less said about that, the better, I feel. Let's carry on to the end of the level. Yes. Oh, it never fails to amuse me the way that you get so far away from the supercomputer and the sound stops. It's just brilliant. No free soda cans for me today, unfortunately, although, you know, me clumsily bashing it with a mace would most probably just damage the mechanism inside rather than, you know, dispense a free Coke can. And even if I had a free Coke can out of it, what would I do with it? Because clearly Anne is going to struggle getting it, levering it up to her mouth. With such a horrendously poor arm that she has been born with, unfortunately. But it's not nice to make fun of disabled people, so what we're going to do is just discern what we need to do next. And now, you will never, ever come to this realisation on your own, but when you turn on a supercomputer, some of these doors unlock. And which ones unlock and which don't? Well, it's just, you know, basically all you've got to do is just go for a little trial and error and just have a bit of a guess and bash your face into a few of them. But it is, in fact, this one which unlocks... And we find a raptor inside, and he is not pretty happy to see us, but we're just going to hit him in the face with a mace a bit. And he goes down like a sack of spuds, and we are happy with that one. Unfortunately, the mace will be taken away from us as soon as we exit the level, but never mind, we're just going to throw it in the lake. Well, that's not really a lake, I guess it's more of a puddle, but never mind. You know, how can I be expected to discern the difference between a lake and a puddle? It's just a question of semantics, I tell you, and nothing more. And so we have a lovely physics-based climbing puzzle here, and frankly, it's a load of old shit. But let's just see if we can drag this bastard up. And yes, unfortunately, that's not going to be close enough, Anne. So I'm just going to chuck that down there. And somehow I managed to get it right end up somehow, which is what was necessary. And here we go for another 10 minutes of trying to jump on a crate. Yes, and after abusing the wonky physics so we can travel upwards on a vertical surface, we find ourselves nearly at the end of the level, and aren't we all relieved? I know that I certainly am. Oh, if I can ever possibly get over this blue wall. Yeah, there we go. So, nearly at the end of the level, we've had to discard our mace, but never mind, we got one good use out of it, I guess, and we are going on to the next level. After a little traipse in the woods. Carrying on for our perilous journey.
The forest smelled of wet leaves, damp earth, rotting wood.
Yes, thank you, John. And before I forget now, we're just going to go back here and pick up our weapons for the day. And we have a choice of three. Well, you'd be stupid to pick anything but the shotgun. And this beauty.
Three left.
Look at him. Oh, yeah. So this is the aforementioned deadly dart gun, which I was waxing lyrical about earlier. And basically, I think it's like a one-shot, one-kill dealy for this game. It's certainly a good one, but you've got to choose your targets wisely, because you do not want to be wasting this bad good boy, because you get free shots, and that's your lot, basically. And the developers being a bit stingy there, I feel. It was just naughty of them, really. And they have stuck a shitload of dinosaurs in this valley. I can spoil that for you.
Of a time when the entire world was covered by an ancient forest. Great hunters stalked in the cool darkness among silent, huge columnar trees, oaks and sequoias.
And John there basically just taking a piss at our predicament that we have to go and fight a shitload of massive dinosaurs. And look at this bad boy here. He is not really looking friendly at the moment, I would say, so we're just going to use this tree to try and defend ourselves from him, just to see if we can confuse his AI long enough to make a quick getaway. He is an ugly bastard. Look at him. Look, I bet that's a face that even a mother couldn't love. I just want to try and defeat his turning circle by defeating him around a tree. Yeah, looks good. Let's go. Quick, Anne, before we suffer a horrendous death or perhaps even just break our ankle walking down here, which of course would mean game over, because Anne cannot continue down a mountain with a broken ankle. It's just not possible, frankly, and I could see why the developers included it in that game. And a velociraptor here, our old friend. Hello, velociraptor, my old friend.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping, let me see while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence.
It's been blatantly put into this island. You know, they just sort of chucked things at random. Oh, Anne can smell the ocean. Well, yeah, worry about that, Anne, and don't worry about, for instance, the two raptors are about to bite us in the ass, but never mind. Anne, all about her priorities there. So there is the ocean, despite the fact we started at an ocean, so it's not a big surprise that we found another part of the ocean here on this island. Oh, shit. You bastard. I'm just trying to mind my own business, and here you are goombering me like a bloody the bastard that you are. Oh, dear.
That's it.
Well, at least he's done
around
for the
10
day. And as for you, mates,
9, 8, 7.
I'm a bit of a shooting gallery there, but
empty.
It's all necessary to Preserve the ammunition. Preserve the ammunition. This is what we want to do in this game, frankly. So we'll carry on. And maybe this Stegosaurus will divert these raptors' attention from me, because I feel like they'd want to attack him better than they do me. He'd get a bit of meal out of him than me, boys. Honestly, you know, just ignore me. Just coming through. I'm not doing anyone any harm. I'll see you. Yep, that's right. Goodbye. Perhaps you'll consider falling off the cliff for me. Is that something you might be able to do for me? That'd be very kind of you. I'd consider it a close personal favour if you were to do that for me. So I'm just going to skirt the cliff edge closely here, just hoping hope beyond hope that they might dispatch themselves by jumping off the cliff. No, he seems to be crushing me. Yep, and this raptor has got the better of us, and he's fallen down the cliff. Well, better late than never again, and this guy's munching on the edge. So thanks a lot for that, and I will see you in the next game of Trespasser. See you later. Oh, stop chewing out my guts, mate. It's just rude.